how to reveal text with mask and animate multiple lines in After Effects. Welcome everyone, I am your host, Elias Serentopoulos. All right, so inside After Effects, I'll go ahead and start this off. I've already placed a photo into the timeline as well as a description text with a layer style of a drop shadow. So I'll go ahead and lock both of these layers so I don't accidentally move them. And to set up the multiple lines, I will get the help of the grids. So under the view menu, I'll choose show grids. Now the event that you want to change the color of the grid, as I did on my end, bring up the After Effects preferences panel, and under the grids and guides, I change the color of the grid as well as the grid line every 100 pixels. So I'll go ahead and zoom in a bit here, and with nothing selected into the timeline, I'll grab the pen tool. A stroke of white color, and the thickness of the stroke is set something between 8 to 10 pixels. So I'll click once to create the first anchor point. And then somewhere in the middle right here, I'll press the shift key and click to create the second anchor point. Now I have a straight segment right there. So I'll go ahead and rename shape layer 1 by pressing enter return on the keyboard and rename this to white line 1. I'm also need to have a duplicate of this line and be placed to the other side. So I'll go ahead and use the keyboard shortcuts. And with the selection tool, just going to click and drag and move this to the other side. I'm also going to zoom in quite a bit here because I want to make sure that both of these lines sit at the very center. So this seems to be okay. As for this one, I'm just going to move it right there. And I want to make sure that there's no gap between those two. All right, so things are looking good here. I got those two lines. Now I need a third line. The third line actually will be the length of both of these lines. So I'll select line 2, duplicate it, lock the other two, press enter return and rename this to red line. I'm also going to change the color of that. There we go. And grab the pen tool again and just click and drag, press the shift key as you do. And make sure I have the correct length here, like so. All right. No need for the grid anymore. So I will disable the grids. And now I have three lines here. All right, so what we need to do now is we need to change the placement of the anchor point for all of these straight segments and set up the ground for the animation. So for the white line one, here's the anchor point. I need to move this to the far right of the line. So I'll go ahead and grab the pen behind anchor point tool and click and drag this and place it right there. I'm also going to zoom in to make sure that I do a good job. And I'll place it right in the center to the far right. This is for the first line. For the second line, I'll do the same, but this time I'll place it to the far left and just right here on the center and the far left. This is for the second and for the third line. The third line, actually, the red line will animate from the very center. And for that, I can actually go to the layer menu, transform, and then choose center anchor point in layer content or use the keyboard shortcuts. And here is the anchor point right at the very center for the red line. All right, so we set up the multiple lines, and now we are ready to go to the next step. The first line to animate, that would be the white line one. So I'll go up to the Add button and bring up the powerful trim paths operator. So let's see which one we're going to animate. This is the start, and this is the end. I'll start with the end And it's because I want this to animate from here and go to the left side. So I am at the beginning of the timeline. I will click on the stopwatch to create the first keyframe and then scrub the current time indicator to, let's say, around here and set the second keyframe to 0%. I'll press the space bar on the keyboard for the RAM preview. And this is what I have so far. All right, so right now I have a linear interpolation, so I'll change that by going to the animation menu, keyframe assistant, and change the interpolation to easy is. So press space bar for another RAM preview, and I have more organic animation. The thing is, I'm actually want to exaggerate the incoming velocity and increase its influence. So I bring up the graph editor. Here's the second keyframe. I will double click on that. Here's the keyframe velocity. This is the incoming velocity. So I'll change the influence to 100%. And press the space bar for another RAM preview. That looks great. All right. So let's go ahead and do something similar to the white line 2 here. Again, I'll go ahead and bring up the trim paths operator. I am at the beginning of the timeline. This time we're going to animate the starts property. So I'll click on the stopwatch to create the first keyframe. And to go to the next visible keyframe, this is the next visible keyframe, I'll press the letter K on the keyboard and change the second keyframe. Set this one to 100%. Mark your select this too. I'll change the interpolation from linear to easy is, and I'll do the same. I'll bring up the graph editor, and here's the incoming velocity. I can also grab the influence handle to 100%. And so the animation basically here is it accelerates fast, it peaks, and then it decelerates. That's the animation here. So let's press the space bar. That looks great. Here's the thing though. I don't want to see those two lines to be visible when they start animating. I want them to be invisible. So for that, I'll actually bring up the scale property and animate only one axis rather than both the X and the Y axis. So I'll start with the white line 1. I am in the beginning of the timeline. So I will press the letter S on the keyboard to bring up the scale property. I will disable the link icon right here. And I'm also going to animate and scale only the X property. You see, this is the X property here. So I am at the beginning of the timeline. I will click on the stopwatch to create the first keyframe. And I'll set this one to 0. So I'm going to scrub the current time indicator to just a little further here. And then set the scale to 100%. I'll do the same for the white line 2. And I press the S on the keyboard for the scale. I will disable this link icon here. I'll make sure that I'm at the beginning of the timeline. I'll set the scale property here, the first one, to 0%. And to go to the next visible keyframe, I'll press the letter K on the keyboard and set the second keyframe to 100%. I'll marquee select all of these. And then under the animation menu, keyframe assistant, I'll change the interpolation to easy is. So let's see how that works by pressing the spacebar. That looks fantastic, actually great and organic animation. So I'll keep that. And now I'm ready to go to the next step and animate the red line. The next line to animate, that will be the red line. So I'll go ahead and focus on that. Now for this red line, I'm only going to animate the scale property. So for that, I'll press the letter S on the keyboard. I'll make sure that I'm at the beginning of the timeline. And once again, I would disable the link icon so I can only animate on the X axis. I will click on the stopwatch to create the first keyframe and I'll set the scale property to 0%. Now to time this correctly, I'll target the second line here, then press the letter U on the keyboard to show properties with keyframes. Now I need to jump to the last visible keyframe. So I use the keyboard shortcut, the letter K twice on the keyboard to jump to the last visible keyframe. And I'll set the scale property not to 100%. The plan here is to actually have some of the red line visible at the very end. So our scale is actually much less, let's say to 15%. You see that? So we have some at the very end. I'll mark you select this too. I'll change the interpolation from linear to as it is. I'll target the second keyframe. I'll bring up the graph editor and change the influence to 100%. This is the incoming velocity. I'll press the spacebar on the keyboard and see the preview of the animation. That looks actually fantastic. Great. One thing that I want to do and make sure that I have consistency is actually copy and paste the layer style, the drop shadow from the description text to the rest of the lines here. So I'll press the letter U twice to bring up the modify properties and I'll target the drop shadow. I'll copy this to the clipboards. Target the first line and paste that. Target the second line and paste that. And then target the red line and paste that as well. So all of these lines do have the same drop shadow property values. So I'll press the spacebar for the round preview. There we go. And now we have consistency throughout. The last thing to animate is to reveal the description text, and for that I'll use a track mat. But first I'll go ahead and set this up. So with nothing selected into the timeline, I grab the rectangle tool and I'm actually using just the fill. The color doesn't really matter. What matters is that I cover the entire description text. So I'll go ahead and click and drag to create a rectangular shape as such. I press enter return on the keyboard to rename this to box. I'm also going to center the anchor point in layer contents. So all transformations take place from the very center right here. All right. So I'll make sure that I'm at the beginning of the timeline and I'm going to animate only the position properties. So for that, I press the letter P on the keyboard and click on the stopwatch to create the first keyframe. And to time this correctly, I'll target the red line and then press the letter U on the keyboard to show properties with keyframes. Now I need to jump to the last visible keyframe. So I press the letter K on the keyboard and I'll set the position property again to be exactly the same as the previous one. Basically right now I have two identical keyframes with the same resting position. So I will scrub the current time indicator to the very beginning and then click and drag and bring this up, let's say around here. So when I press the space bar, this is the animation. All right, now I'll go ahead and marquee select those two keyframes. I'll change the interpolation from linear to as it is. I'll target this one, the second keyframe. And inside the graph editor, I'll change the incoming velocity with an influence of 100%. And then again, I press the space bar to preview the animation. That looks good. Now let's go ahead and work on the track mats. So with the track mats column visible, I will unlock the text layer. I will target it, select it, and then I click on the drop-down menu and select the layer that I want as an alpha mat reference layer. So the reference layer for me is the box. Let's go ahead and do another round preview. Press the space bar. There we go. All right. Now I'm going to go ahead and just time this a little better. And by that, I mean, I'll bring the first position keyframe just a little bit into the timeline right here. Then press the space bar for the round preview. And I like this animation quite a lot. So now let's go ahead and trim the entire composition here. I'm just going to go right here, scrub the current time indicator right there at the end of the animation, and then give a bit of a buffer space, let's say somewhere around here. I press the letter N on the keyboard to set the end of the work area to this current time, and then I will right click to trim comb to work area, and then just press the space bar again for the ramp preview. It looks fantastic, and this is exactly what I wanted to show you for this animation.